Arsenal are ready to make their interest in Noa Lang formal with a £25 million bid, according to reports. The Club Brugge youngster has been on the Gunners' radar for some time but has now hit the headlines with a first international cap for the Netherlands. Mikel Arteta is keen to bring the 22-year-old to the Emirates in January as he looks to enhance his attacking options. The Arsenal boss faces competition from the likes of AC Milan to land the winger's signature. Now Voetbal 24 reports the North London club are preparing a £25 million bid to bring Lang to the Premier League. The Dutchman only moved to Brugge permanently this year, having impressed while on loan from Ajax last season. He was called up to Louis van Gaal's Netherlands squad for their latest Group G World Cup qualifiers. And van Gaal gave him the nod in the 1-0 victory over Latvia as he was brought on with 30 minutes left. Arsenal were set to wait until next summer to make their move when Eddie Nketiah and Alexander Lacazette will be out of contract and likely to leave. But with Milan circling, Gunners officials are understood to be readying a January bid. Arsenal were the biggest Premier League spenders in the most recent window, splashing out around £150 million on a host of new signings. Ben White, Aaron Ramsdale, Martin Odegaard, Nuno Tavares, Albert Lokongo and Takahiro Tomiyasu all arrived through the door. And things have begun to improve following a shaky start to their Premier League campaign, with Arteta recently named Manager of the Month. Jack Wilshere offers update on his next move after linking up with old club Arsenal. Jack Wilshere insists he has no plans to call time on his playing career to focus on coaching. The 29-year-old is currently back at his old side Arsenal in a bid to keep up his fitness as he searches for a new club. The former England international is a free agent following his release from Bournemouth at the end of last season, having also spent time with Serie B side Como during the summer. In recent weeks, Wilshere has also been working with former teammate Per Mertesacker, who serves as the head of the Gunners Academy. While he is currently doing his coach's badges, Wilshere insists that will be something he explores later down the line with his current focus on continuing his playing career. At the moment I am doing my coaching badges and the club is helping me with them and I am helping some of the academy kids out as well, Wilshere told Sky Sports News. It is certainly something I enjoy and maybe something to look at in the future, but for now I still want to play. I feel like I still have a lot to give and something to prove, which is why I don't want to finish playing now and start a coaching career just yet. It's nice to be back seeing some old faces who I spent a lot of my life with. Wilshere also revealed he will be back at Arsenal until January and hopes to have a new club by that point. Fitness-wise I am getting there and it's great to be back training with good players and the quality is only going to be beneficial for me moving forward. I'm there at Arsenal until January and there's no news on any clubs but hopefully something will come up then. Many Arsenal fans want Jack Wilshere will find the new club to continue to play football. We want to see his style to play with the ball. It's such a beautiful football of Arsenal and hope he will do it again in the near future. Try your best, Wilshere. Mikel Arteta believes Thomas Partey possesses a quiet determination that he hopes will embody the new Arsenal. The Ghanaian was the Gunners' standout signing in 2020, joining the club in the final hours of the transfer window after Arsenal activated a £45 million release clause in the midfielder's contract. However, despite some early promise, injuries restricted Partey to just 24 league appearances during his debut campaign at the Emirates. Partey has featured in each of Arsenal's last four victories in the league and Arteta is hopeful that he can step up in Granit Xhaka's absence, with the Switzerland international not expected to return until December. Arteta is trying to reset the club's culture after their recent decline and ESPN claims he wants the silent determination that Partey possesses to become a main ingredient of the new Arsenal. A struggle to settle in the capital combined with an injury-hit debut campaign was frustrating for Partey, but the midfielders adapted his conditioning since to minimize the threat of muscle injuries. The Ghanaian is reportedly doing more leg work to combat the physical nature of the Premier League and to ensure he's capable of taking the knocks that are part and parcel of football in England. Arteta feels Partey can become a figurehead of the team, particularly in Xhaka's absence. At 28, Partey is one of the most experienced players at the club and Arteta will be hoping he can continue the fine form he's shown for Ghana during the international break when he returns to his club this week. Partey scored twice in two games for Ghana, including a stunning free kick against Zimbabwe. Hope he will bring this level to play for Arsenal, and Arsenal need his high form to lift the team up on the rank of Premier League. Thierry Henry questions whether Arsenal are going in the right direction under Mikel Arteta. Thierry Henry has questioned whether Arsenal are heading in the right direction under Mikel Arteta following their 0-0 draw against Brighton. After starting the season with three consecutive Premier League defeats, Arsenal are currently on a four-match unbeaten streak, a run which includes an emphatic 3-1 win over North London rivals Tottenham. But in their last match at the Amex Stadium, the Gunners were second best in almost every department, with Arteta conceding after the game that his side were lucky to come away with a point. After watching the match against the Seagulls, Premier League icon Henry has admitted that he isn't convinced by his former club's recent results and has questioned whether they are making enough progress under the Spanish boss. "I don't know if things are going in the right direction. I watched the Brighton game. Did you watch it?" Henry said at the Prime Video Presents Sport 2021 showcase event. "I've seen us beating Norwich before, winning at Burnley, beating Tottenham at home, because we always beat Tottenham at home. I was more than happy when we beat Tottenham as we were on a good run, but I was waiting to see a performance, away from home, against a team that passes the ball. And, instead, we suffered. I was waiting to see the Brighton game, to see if we could have the ball and keep the ball, away from home, retaining possession, against a dangerous Brighton side. When we used to lose, even after I left the team, it was always said that Arsenal don't have a plan B and that they passed too much for the sake of passing. But I didn't see that from Arsenal in the Brighton match. I saw Brighton do that." The Gunners will be looking to prove Henry wrong when they welcome Crystal Palace to the Emirates on Monday night. Another win will help Mikel Arteta and Arsenal continue unbeaten streak, and hope we will do it to make the happiness for the fans. Ray Parlour rules Arsenal out of race for Champions League qualification. Ray Parlour believes that Arsenal should be competing to finish in 5th or 6th place in the Premier League table this season, but thinks the top 4 is currently out of their reach. Arsenal currently has had the branch of impressive matches with 4 unbeaten streak, but former Arsenal midfielder Parlour thinks that the club can push themselves into a European spot this term, despite being held to a 0-0 draw against high-flying Brighton in their last match. "Before the game, if Arsenal got a win it would have been brilliant, but I would have taken a draw against Brighton. I'm going by being realistic," Parlour told TalkSport. "Arsenal are not going to be in the top 4 this season, they're competing for 5th and 6th. They're still in the hunt alongside Everton, West Ham, Spurs. West Ham are flying at the moment. I've had a bet that Arsenal will finish above both West Ham and Spurs. Arsenal spent more than £150 million on 6 new signings in the summer, the most of any Premier League club, but Parlour believes they must continue to invest if they hope to achieve success. I think they'll have a good season, and I think you have to give Mikel Arteta time. It's a situation where they've got to keep investing. They've invested a lot of money in the summer, whether it's the right investment remains to be seen. I think the back four will be very important. I was with former Arsenal manager George Graham yesterday. If this Arsenal team can get that back four right like it was in his era, get the goalkeeper right. If you can keep the current back four fit and keep it solid. He might have a chance this year, Arteta. We have to wait for the end of this season to know the verdict of Ray Parlour about Arsenal is right or not. But with an Arsenal fans, I'm truly believe that Arsenal will totally finish in the top 4 this season. What's about your thought? Please give me your prediction about where is position of Arsenal in this season. Arsenal coach Per Mertesacker has hailed Bukayo Saka and has challenged him to get the Gunners back in Champions League. He said, "Bukayo has the mindset of a lifelong learner, and I can only congratulate his parents for raising a son who is so humble, so respectful and so disciplined. Watching him play for England fills us with so much pride, and even the huge disappointment of missing that penalty at the Euros was the making of him. We absolutely love it that he is such an inspiration who always stays true to himself along the bumpy pathway and has not been distracted by the shiny things that will come to him, such as contracts and money. He has never lost sight of the fact that he is really fortunate to work under such privileged circumstances, and those principles will last longer than any contract that he might sign. We are giving the first team what Arsenal needs to be competitive again, with young players at the forefront, and we're asking Bukayo and Emile Smith Rowe to lead us back into the Champions League.